اللهم اجعلنا منهم اللهم اجعلنا منهم اللهم اجعلنا منهم آمين يا رب العالمين. This is Surah Ar-Rum. I should have told you that in the Mushaf now we are having four surahs which are starting with these alphabets Alif Lam Mim. First was Surah Al-Ankabut. We have already read it. Second is Surah Ar-Rum. Third is going to be Surah Al-Luqman. And the fourth Surah Al-Sajdah. These are the four Makki surahs which start with Alif Lam Mim. Then we have in the very beginning of Quran, two Madani surahs which start with the same letters, Alif Lam Mim, Surah Al-Baqarah or Surah Al-Imran. Now these surahs, they actually were revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during the middle 4 years of his stay at Makkah. I told you, the Makki period can be divided into three parts. First 4 years, middle 4 years, then the last 4 years. The first two main groups of Makki surahs, Surah Al-An'am, Araf, and then the 14 surahs, from Surah Al-Yunus to Surah Al-Mu'minun, they were revealed during the last 4 years of his stay at Makkah, except for Surah Al-Hijr. Then these two groups, one group which has started from after Surah Al-Nur, Al-Furqan, Al-Shu'ara, Al-Naml, Al-Qasas. Then Surah Al-Ankabut, Surah Al-Rum, Surah Al-Luqman, and Surah Al-Sajdah. And then will come another surah, Madani surah, that is Ahzab. And then after Ahzab, 13 Makki surahs. So these are the surahs, 8 plus 13, 21, which were mostly revealed during the middle 4 years of his stay, of the stay of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam at Makkah. Except for Surah Shu'ara. There are exceptions, but generally those rules hold. Now this surah was definitely revealed just like Surah Al-Ankabut in the 5th or 6th year after the beginning of Wahi on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the same way it is also definite that it was revealed in the 6th or 5th year after the beginning of Wahi to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alif Lam Mim Ghulibat Ar-Rum. The Romans have been defeated. Fi Adna Al-Ard. In the land close by. وَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ غَلَبِهِمْ سَيَغْلِبُونَ. And after this defeat of theirs, they will soon be victorious. فِي بِذْعِ سِنِينَ. In a few years. لِلَّهِ الْأَمْرُ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَمِنْ بَعْدُ. To Allah belongs the command before and after. وَيَوْمَ إِذِي يَفْرَحُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And on that day, the believers will also be rejoicing. بِنَصْرِ اللَّهِ. With the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَنْصُرُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. He helps whomsoever he wants. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ. And he is the mighty one, the merciful. وَعَدَ اللَّهِ. This is the promise of Allah. لَا يُخْلِفُ اللَّهُ وَعَدَهُ. Allah doesn't go back on his promise. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of the people know not. Now it is clear from these six ayats that there is the historical background behind it. First of all, you should have an idea that the Arabian Peninsula is like this. And over this peninsula is Syria on the left side and Iraq on the right. These are also part of Arab world. Iraqul Arab, Shamul Arab and Al Jazeera. These are the three parts of the Arab world. Iraqul Arab, Shamul Arab and Al Jazeera, the Arabian Peninsula. Now there were two superpowers of that age. One was the Roman Empire. One was the Iranian Empire. These were the two superpowers of that time. For several hundred years, they were, you know, the superpowers. And then, you know, history had been playing a game of seesaw between the two empires. Sometimes the Romans came to the east and they ran over most of the area that was occupied by the Iranians and defeated them. Sometimes the Iranians advanced and pushed the Romans into the Asia Minor. Roman Empire was a very big empire. It had its occupied areas in the north of Africa, west of Asia, and east of Europe. But then, you know, if the Iranians advanced, they pushed these Romans into Anatolia, the Asia Minor. And when the Christians, these Romans, they advanced, they pushed Iranians back. Now, what happened in the year? It was year 615, when Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had been giving his dawah for 5 years. Revelation started to come to him in the year 610. In 615 AD, Romans got a very big defeat at the hands of the Iranians. All this area, Syria, was gone from their hands, Jerusalem gone from their hands. You know, and for those Christians, that was a very sacred area. So a very big downfall came on the Roman Empire. Now, because the Iranians were the worshippers of the fire, the idolaters of Makkah and Arabia, they rejoiced. And they taunted to the Muslims, these people, the Christians, they are nearer to you. They are the people of the book. You accept Jesus. Now they have been defeated. And they are more nearer to us. They are worshipping fire. And we are worshipping these idols. So they are our brothers. And they have triumphed. So this was the event which was very important. And due to this, the Muslims were also somewhat depressed, because the people of the book were defeated by those who were worshipping fire. Alif Lam Mim, غُلِبَتِ الرُّومُ فِي أَدْنَى الْأَرْضِ وَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ غَلَبِهِمْ سَيَغْلِبُونَ فِي بِضْعِ سِنِينَ. On this, Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu entered into a betting agreement with one of the kuffar of Makkah, that if this prophecy, Quran says that within a few years, the Romans will have the victory again. فِي بِضْعِ سِنِينَ, in a few years. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَمْرُ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَمِنْ بَعْدُ. To Allah belongs the authority before also and after also. On this he bet, and he entered into an agreement of betting, that if this prophecy doesn't come true in 3 years, then I'll give you 100 camels. If it comes true, you give me 100 camels. But the Prophet said, you have committed a mistake. The word biza in Arabic, it covers the figure up till 9, less than 10. So you change your bet, increase the number of the years to 9, and you can increase also the number of the camels. So he changed his bet accordingly. Exactly in the 9 years after this event, in the year 624, the tables were turned. Heraclius, the Roman emperor, he now invaded Iran from the northern area, from, you know, this, between the Caspian, from where the Gogs and Magogs used to come in the ancient times. The way was blocked by Cyrus or Zulkarnain. We have read it in Surah Al-Kahf. From Armenia and Azerbaijan, he came down and he gave a very, very big defeat to the Iranians. So the prophecy came to be true. Alif Lam Mim, غُلِبَتِ الرُّومُ, the Romans have been defeated. فِي أَدْنَى الْأَرْضِ, in the close by land. Now land is Syria, etc., was very close to the Arabian Peninsula. وَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ غَلَبَهِمْ سَيَغْلِبُونَ, and after this defeat of theirs, they will again be victorious. فِي بِضْعِ سِنِينَ, in a few years, less than 10. لِلَّهِ الْأَمْرُ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَمِنْ بَعْدُ, to Allah belongs the authority before and even also after. وَيَوْمَئِذٍ يَفْرَحُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, on that day, the Mu'mins, the believers, will also be rejoicing. Why? The same year, Muslims got the victory of Badr. Same year, 624. On the one hand, Christians defeated the Iranians, the worshippers of fire. And the Muslims, they defeated the army at Badr of Kufar, which was led by Abu Jahl. So, يَوْمَئِذِي يَفْرَحُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, the believers here in the Arabian Peninsula, they will also be rejoicing, بِنَصْرِ اللَّهِ, with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَنْصُرُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ, he helps whomsoever he likes, وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ, and he is all-powerful and all-merciful. وَعَدَ اللَّهِ, and this is the promise of Allah. لَا يُخْلِفُ اللَّهُ وَعَدَهُ, Allah doesn't go back on his promise, وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, but most of the people know not, they don't know. يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, even of this world, this life of this world, they only know the outside of it, outward aspect of this life. I was asked a question regarding the ayah of Surah Al-Ankabut. وَمَا هَذِ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَهْوٌ وَلَعِبٌ. Now this life of this world is nothing but amusement and play. The brother asked, but Allah says, مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلَا. This world and this creation is not purposeless. So now here it is being said that this is all amusement. So answer is, if this life blocks your vision of Akhirah, then it is nothing. It is just, you know, a dhoka, a deceit, and nothing else. Mata'ul ghurur, a material of deceit. But if you know Akhirah also, and use this dunya to earn Akhirah, then this is the most important part of our life. And this is given in a hadith, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ad-dunya mazra'atul akhirah. This dunya, this world, is the sowing field for Akhirah. You sow here to reap there. But if you don't sow here, what will you reap in the Akhirah? In that regard, it's most important. Each and every second, I said while explaining Surah Al-Mu'minun, each and every second of this life is very important. Because what you are doing, that is going to be rewarded in a life which is eternal, no end. So therefore, potentially each second of this life becomes eternal, potentially eternal, because its results are going to be spread over an eternal time. So hence, this life is very important. But if it has blocked your vision of the Akhirah, and you are lost in this world, then this is nothing but a drama, nothing but an amusement, nothing but a game. يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. They are seeing out of this worldly life also, they are seeing only the exterior of it. وَهُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ. Regarding the Akhirah, they are absolutely heedless. Because in this world also, if you peep down into your hearts, if you search your souls, you will find something. But mostly people keep themselves engaged in the external world, world outside. Keep busy. Never think, never, you know, ponder over something. Never search your souls. Never peep down into your hearts. So this is actually the present society. In the next surah, you will find people, you know, today have invented methods to keep people busy. Don't let them think. They should be busy with the television. They should be busy with the games. Cricket is going on. Oh, everybody is talking about it. And you know, people are just tied up to their television sets. And they are losing time and everything. And these things, they have attracted people. And they don't have any time. Either you are going to your work, there you are busy with your work there. Job. And job, you know, is the most important thing here. It's the biggest ilah in America. Job is the biggest ilah. You must have a job, otherwise you are nowhere. So, either you are in job or you are in amusement. You are never alone to yourself to be able to think. And then you go to sleep taking some sleeping pill. Go off. Not thinking. If you think, and if you meditate, and if you peep down your hearts, if you search your souls, you will find. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. There are our signs within you also, but you don't see them. أَوَلَمْ يَتَفَكَّرُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ. The same subject has come. Have they never pondered over their own selves, reflected over them? مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. Allah has not created the heavens and the earth and whatever is between the two, but with truth and with purpose. وَأَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. And an appointed term. This creation is not eternal. It will not remain forever. As I said in the last lecture, a time will come when nothing will exist except Allah. كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانْ وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ. كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَا. In the end of Surah Al-Qasas, we had this ayah. وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّهِمْ لَكَافِرُونَ. But most of the people, they are refusing that they are going to meet their Lord. أَوَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَيَنْظُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Have they not travelled in the land and saw for themselves what was the end of those who were before them. Kanu ashadda minhum quwwa. They were more in might and power than them. This nation of Aad was a very mighty nation and a very big culture. Aw asaru al-ardha wa abaruha akthara mimma abaruha. And they tilled the land and built upon it more than these have built. وَجَاءَتْهُمْ رُسُلُهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. And to them also our messengers came with our clear signs and clear teachings. فَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ. Well, Allah was not unjust to them. وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. But actually they were doing wrong to themselves. ثُمَّ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ أَسَاءُوا السُّوءَ. Then the end of those who had done evil was evil. It had to be evil. أَنْ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. That they rejected the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَانُوا بِهَا يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. To add insult to injury, they were mocking at the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were laughing and mocking. اللَّهُ يَبْدَعُ الْخَلْقَ ثُمَّ يُعِدُهُ. It is Allah who originates the creation and then repeats it. ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. In the same way, He has created you and then you will again be recreated, resurrected, and then you will be returned to Him. وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ يُبْلِسُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ. And when that hour comes, well, these guilty people shall be absolutely disappointed and despaired. They will have no hope. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُمْ مِنْ شُرَكَائِهِمْ شُفَعَوْا. They will have no intercessors on their behalf from those whom they thought that they are the partners of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَانُوا بِشُرَكَائِهِمْ كَافِرِينَ. And then they will be denying their shuraka there. وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَفَرَّقُونَ. And when this hour will come, they will be divided. Divided into whom? فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ فَهُمْ فِي رَوْضَةٍ يُحْبَرُونَ. As for those who had come to believe and who had done good deeds, they will be happy in a garden. وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَكَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَلِقَاءِ الْآخِرَةِ. And as for those who rejected the faith and belied our revelations and belied that they were to meet us, فَأُولَٰئِكَ فِي الْعَذَابِ مُحْضَرُونَ. They will be brought forth to the worst chastisement. فَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ هِنَا تُنْسُونَ وَهِنَا تُصْبِحُونَ. So Allah be glorified when you enter the evening and when you enter the morning. وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And for Him is the praise in the heavens and the earth. وَعَشِيًّا وَهِنَا تُصْبِحُونَ. And you should praise Him and glorify Him in the afternoon also. And when the sun declines to the west during the noon. يُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ. He brings forth the living from the dead. وَيُخْرِجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ. And brings forth the dead from the living. وَيُحْيِي الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. And He gives life, revives the earth after its death. وَكَذَلِكَ تُخْرَجُونَ. And in the same way, you will be taken out from the land, from the earth. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ. Now, in this section, third section of this surah, you will see repeatedly, مِنْ آيَاتِهِ. مِنْ آيَاتِهِ. As we had in Surah Al-Nahl, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يَسْمَعُونَ. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يُبْصِرُونَ. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يَفْقَهُونَ. This is, but the pattern and style is different, subject is the same. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ. It is from His signs. خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ. That He created you out of mud. ثُمَّ إِذَا أَنْتُمْ بَشَرٌ تَنْتَشِرُونَ. And then, behold, you are mortals, human beings, scattered around, moving. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ. And from amongst His signs, أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. That He created from your own selves, or we may call from your own species, wives for you. لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. So that you have repose in them. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. And He produced between you love and affection and mercy. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. In this are the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His wisdom, His creation, His power, His authority. But for those who ponder, who reflect, who think, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And from His signs are the creation of the heavens and the earth. وَاخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ. and the diversity and difference in your tongues and colors and hues. Inna fi zalika la ayatil lil alameen. In these are the signs for those people who know. Wa min ayatihi manamukum bil layli wan nahar. And from amongst his ayat and signs is your sleeping during the night and the day. The midday, you know, afternoon nap also included in the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But people in the West absolutely deprived from it. We in the East enjoy this blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take some time out during afternoon for the nap. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ مَنَامُكُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ. You're sleeping during the night and the day. وَابْتِغَاؤُكُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِ. And then you're seeking the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the day. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يَسْمَعُونَ. Verily in these are the ayat, the signs for those people who listen. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ يُرِيكُمُ الْبَرْقَ خَوْفٌ وَطَمَعٌ. And from his signs is that he shows you the lightning with fear and hope. Maybe some cyclone is coming, so that is the fear. Maybe Maab Mubarakah, good rain is coming, that is the hope. But when you see lightning, you know, both these things occur to you. وَيُنَزُّلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. And he sends down from the heaven water. فَيُحْيِي بِهِ الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. And revives the earth, the land, after it was dead. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يَعْقِلُونَ. Verily, in this are the signs for those people who have the understanding. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ تَقُومَ السَّمَاءُ وَالْأَرْضُ بِأَمْرِهِ. And it is from amongst his signs that the heaven and earth, they keep staying balanced. They keep staying balanced. ثُمَّ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ دَعْوَةً مِنَ الْأَرْضُ. Then he will call you. One call from the earth, إِذَا أَنْتُمْ تُخْرَجُونَ. You will be coming out and you will emerge from your graves. وَلَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And to him belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. كُلُّ لَهُ قَانِتُونَ. All are obedient to him. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَبْدَوْ الْخَلْقَ ثُمَّ يُعِيدُهُ. He is the one who creates, originates his creation. And then he will repeat. وَهُوَ أَهْوَنُ عَلَيْهِ. And that is easier on him. To create for the first time was difficult. But to repeat it is easy. وَلَهُ الْمَثَلُ الْعَالَى. And to him are the loftiest similitudes in the فِي and the highest attributes in the heaven and the earth. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيدُ الرَّحِيمُ حَكِيمُ. And he is the all-powerful, all-wise. ظَلَمَ لَكُمْ مَثَلًا مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strikes a similitude from yourselves. هَلْ لَكُمْ مِمَّا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ مِنْ شُرَكَاءَ فِي مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ فَأَنْتُمْ فِيهِ سَوَاءٌ. Do you have from amongst your slaves, whom your right hands possess, from them do you have shurakas, associates, equals, in what we have given you? You make them your partners, so that you become equal with each other. You are the master, you have a slave. You own this, 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 this. Do you include this slave in this ownership? No. Quran takes the similitudes from the society. The society was there. The slaves were there, the masters were there. Now no master was ready to make his slave a partner with the, in his property. تَخَافُونَهُمْ كَخِيفَتِكُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Do you care for them as much as you care for yourself? If you are sick, you run to the doctor. You give the highest fee. But as for your slave, do you care that much? Maybe you send him to the community hospital, you know, to go there. But you don't care for him as you care for you. So can Allah adopt partners from his own creation? How come? If you can't imagine it for yourself. كَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يَعْقِلُونَ. In this way, we detail our ayat, our revelations for those people who know. بَلِ اتَّبَعَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَهْوَاهُمْ. But these evildoers actually, they are following their desires and lusts. They are not following their intellect. They are not following the reasoning. They are following the desires and lusts and the wishes of the id or the libido. بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ and they have no knowledge. فَمَنْ يَهْدِي مَنْ أَضَلَّ اللَّهِ So who can bring to the right path the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent astray? وَمَا لَهُمْ مِنْ نَاصِرِينَ And for them there are no helpers. فَأَقِمْ وَجْهَكَ لِلدِّينِ حَنِيفًا So keep your face fixed for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as absolute upright mean of pure faith. فطرت الله التي فطر الناس عليها This is the true nature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on which He has created human beings also. This ana, this self, this is in Allah, ana. And a small ana He has put in us also. As I told you, Allama Iqbal says, the infinite ego of Allah and the finite ego of man, they come face to face in prayer. When I'm praying, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Maliki, Yawm al-Din, Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. Now I'm conversing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm face to face. That's why the Prophet said, As-salatu mirajul mu'mineen. This is like miraj. If you have the real salah, you are praying really, then it is equal to miraj. فَاقِمْ وَجَهَكَ لِلْدِينِ حَنِفَةً فِطْرَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي فَطَرَ النَّاسُ عَلَيْهَا لَا تَبْدِيلَ لِخَلْقِ اللَّهِ There can be no change in the creation of Allah. ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ So this is the right religion, the system of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which will stay forever. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ But most of the people know not. مُنِيبِينَ إِلَيْهِ O believers, turn to Him, وَاتَّقُوهُ and fear Him. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ And establish the prayer. وَلَا تَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ And don't in any way be with those who are associating anything or anyone with Allah in any way. مِنَ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ From among those who have divided their deen, who have split up their deen, كُلُّ حِزْبٍ بِمَا لَدَيْهِمْ فَرِحُونَ And every group and every sect is rejoicing with what they have. You know, this deen is a whole. But then, when a messenger of Allah came, he gave you the whole deen. After him, after a few generations, now people split the deen. And this part is taken by the ulama. This part is taken by the sufia. The politics is taken by the salatin and kings. That one deen has been split into three. Then there are sects. According to different sects of beliefs and creeds. So now everyone has one part of deen and he is rejoicing that I have the best deen. So this is the condition of the sects, you know, in the deen of Allah. When there is a downfall, a degradation, then that deen becomes split into sects. وَإِذَا مَسَّ النَّاسُ ضُرٌّ دَعَوْا رَبَّهُمْ مُنِيبِينَ إِلَيْهِ And when some affliction touches the mankind, they call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fully turning to Him. ثُمَّ إِذَا أَذَاقَهُمْ مِنْهُ رَحْمَةً When He makes them taste mercy from Him, إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِنْهُمْ بِرَبِّهِمْ يُشْرِكُونَ Then some of them begin to make, to declare associates with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيَكْفُرُوا بِمَا أَتَيْنَاهُمْ So that they should be ungrateful. But with what we have given them, فَتَمَتَّعُوا What we have given them, they are spending in sin. We gave them this thing and he is spending this for a sin. We gave him this money and he is using it to purchase liquor. So our blessings, they are actually being ungrateful to us. فَسَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ So very soon they will come to know the reality. أَمْ أَنزَلَّ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٌ فَهُوَ يَتَكَلَّمُ بِمَا كَانُوا بِهِ يُشْرِكُونَ Have we sent down to some proof, some scripture, which says to them that these are actually associated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no scripture in the world, no allegedly divine scripture coming from heaven, which says that this is the associators with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا أَذَقْنَا النَّاسَ رَحْمَةً فَرِحُوا بِهَا And when we make people taste our mercy, So they rejoice with it. وَإِنْتَصِبْهُمْ سَيِّئَةٌ. And if some affliction comes to them, بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ, due to what their both hands have sent forward, إِذَا هُمْ يَقْنُطُونَ, then they become absolutely disappointed and despaired. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. Don't they see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala outspreads the provision for whomsoever He wills and restricts for whomsoever He wills. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمِ يُؤْمِنُونَ. In these are the signs for those who believe. فَآتِذَ الْقُرْبَى حَقَّهُ. So, O the one who believes, you give your relatives their right, their due. You have to pay them, you have to help them. آتِذَ الْقُرْبَى حَقَّهُ. And this is their right. وَالْمِسْكِينَ. And the needy. وَابْنَ السَّبِيلِ. And the traveler or the wayfarer. ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ. This is better for those who seek the countenance of Allah, the face of Allah, that is, the pleasure of Allah. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And definitely, they are the ones who will prosper in the hereafter. وَمَا أَتَيْتُمْ مِنْ رِبًا لَيَرْمُوَ فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ. And whatever you give on usury or interest, so that your money grows with the money of the people. You have given someone $1,000. Now he is doing his business. His own money is there, and your $1,000 are also mixed with them. Due to his work, his hard work, this money is growing. And your $10,000 are also growing with them, with that, without any effort from you. And you are charging interest on it. This is riba. This is haram. وَمَا أَتَيْتُمْ مِنْ رِبًا لَيَرْبُوَ فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ. Whatever you give to people on interest or usury, so that it should increase in the wealth of the people. فَلَا يَرْبُوْ إِنَّ اللَّهِ. It doesn't increase at all. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا أَتَيْتُمْ مِنْ زَكَاتٍ. And whatsoever you give for charity, تُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ. And you want the countenance of Allah, the pleasure of Allah with that. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُضْعِفُونَ. Only they will be, they shall have manifold increase. So riba is absolutely opposed to zakah. What is riba? There is some surplus with you. You are earning, your needs are fulfilled, you have saved something. Now this saving is surplus with you. Now with this surplus, you can do two things. Either you invest it again into earning, or you give it for the charity. First choice should be, you give it for the charity. يَسْأَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ قُلِ الْعَفْوَ. This surplus actually should be given in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Either in charity to the needy people, or for the deen of Allah, to propagate it and to make it established in the land. But if you want some investment, then that investment should be halal. It should be muzaraba or musharaka. No riba. What is riba? You say, okay brother, you take this money, you do business. I never care whether you earn something or you lose something. I will get 10% from you, or 12% or 20%. This is haram. And there is nothing in Islam more haram than this. Even adultery is nothing before it. Because the Prophet says, الربا سبعون حبوبا. 70 sins are there in one sin of riba. And these 70 are not equal. Some are greater, some are smaller sins. أَسَرُوْهَا. The least and the smallest of these sins is equal to أَنْ يَنْكَهَ الرَّجُلْ أُمَّهُ. That a man commits adultery with his own mother. This is the ratio proportion. وَمَا أَتَيْتُمْ مِنْ رِبًا لَيَرْبُوَ فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ فَلَا يَرْبُوْ إِنْدَ اللَّهِ. وَمَا أَتَيْتُمْ مِنْ زَكَاتٍ تُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُزَفُونَ. اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ ثُمَّ رَزَقَكُمْ. Allah is He who has created you, then He has provided you sustenance. ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ, then He will put you to die. ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ, then He will revive you. هَلْ مِنْ شُرَكَائِكُمْ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ مِنْ ذَٰلِكُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. Is there anyone whom you are associating with Allah who can do anything among these? Subhanah. Glory is for Allah. وَتَعَالَى مَا يُشْرِكُونَ. And He is high and above. from all those things with which they are association. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Corruption and mischief has come up and covered the whole globe, the land as well as the oceans, due to what the hands of people have earned. لَيُزِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا. So that Allah should taste them, make them taste reward of some of their sins. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Maybe their eyes are opened and they come back. Now you know this world, all the crises, water crisis is threatening, pollution is threatening, then the population explosion is threatening, then there are weapons of destruction, mass destruction, biological, chemical, atomic, all these things. What is this world? A fearful thing now. There is facade. At any time, if by mistake, you know, some button is pressed, maybe this just explodes, this whole earth might explode. Because immediately there will be an atomic attack from this side, and immediately there will be a response from the other side. What will happen then? ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر. But there is another meaning of this facade. Today on the whole of the world, there is a revolt against Allah. Even those who believe in Allah, they are not ready to take Him and accepting Him as their ruler. We are our own rulers. Sovereignty belongs to us. We will frame the laws. Our representatives will sit and they will make the rules. We don't care about any divine rule and divine laws, what He has prohibited and what He has permitted. We don't care. We are the sovereigns. This is global revolt against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rebellion. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Now what is humanity tasting, you know, the bad taste of these things. قل سيروا في الأرض. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go around this land. فَانْظُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلُ. See for themselves what was the end of those who were before them. كَانَ أَكْسَرْهُمْ مُشْرِكِينَ. Most of them were the idolaters, the associators with Allah of some or some other deities. فَأَقِمْ وَجْهَكَ لِلدِّينِ الْقَيِّمِ. So you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and through you, through Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I am being addressed and you are being addressed. You keep your set fixed and set for the deen of Allah, and which is everlasting deen. The deen which will go on and go on till the end of this world. فَأَقِمْ وَجْهَكَ لِلدِّينِ الْقَيِّمِ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ يَوْمٌ لَا مَرَدَّ لَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ. Before that time comes of your death, or of that hour of Qiyamah, which will not be able to be averted by anybody. يَوْمَ إِذِنْ يَصَّدَّعُونَ. On that day, they will be divided. مَنْ كَفَرَ فَعَلَيْهِ كُفْرُهُ. Whosoever had disbelieved, so upon him will be the burden of disbelief. وَمَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا. And whosoever had done good deeds, فَلِأَنفُسِهِمْ يَمْهَدُونَ. So they are providing for their own selves. لَيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. So that Allah may reward those who have the real faith and do good deeds. مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. From His bounty. إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرُونَ. Verily, He doesn't like those who disbelieve. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ يُسْرَ الرِّيَاءُ مُبَشِّرَاتٍ. And it is also from His signs that He sends the winds, bringing the glad tidings that rain is coming and coming. People were waiting, waiting, waiting for the rain. And now, you know, that breeze has come, as if a message has come that the rain is near. وَلَيُذِيقَكُمْ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ. I said, right, He should make you taste His mercy. وَلِتَجْرِيَ الْفُلْكُ بِأَمْرِهِ. And so that there is water in the rivers, and you know, the ships can move. وَلِتَبْتَهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. So that you can seek Allah's bounties, you by trading through the sea routes. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. But the end result of all of this should be that you should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ رُسُلًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ. And before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we sent many messengers to their nations. فَجَاؤُهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتُ. They came to them with clear signs and clear teachings. فَانْتَقَمْنَا مِنَ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا. Then we take our vengeance, we took the vengeance upon those who were guilty. وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And it was binding upon us that we had to help the believers. It was the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all the messengers of Allah, Nuh and Hud and Saleh and so on and so forth, that you will be saved in the end. When that chastisement will come, all these disbelievers will be destroyed, but you and your companion believers will be saved. وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. اللَّهُ الَّذِي يُرْسِلُ الرِّيَاحَ فَتُصِيرُ صَحَابًا. Allah is He who sends winds, and they raise a cloud. فَيَبْسُطُهُ فِي السَّمَاءِ. Then Allah spreads that cloud in the heaven. كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. As He likes. وَيَجْعَلُهُ كِسَفًا. Then it divides into fragments. فَتَرَى الْوَدْقَ يَخْرُجُ مِنْ خِلَالِهِ. And then you see rain is coming from in between them. فَإِذَا أَصَابَ بِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He takes this rain to some of the persons from His bondsmen, well, they rejoice that now our fields, you know, had water, and now our crops will, you know, come up. وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ تُنْيُنَزْرَ عَلَيْهُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ لَمُبْلِسِينَ. Although, surely, before the coming of the rain, they were absolutely disappointed and despaired. فَانْظُرْ إِلَىٰ أَثَارِ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. So see the marks of Allah's mercy. كَيْفَ يُحْيِي الْأَرْضَ. How He revives the land بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. After its death. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لَمُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. Verily, He who is doing this, reviving the earth after death, He will revive the dead also. وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. And He is powerful to do everything. وَلَئِنْ أَرْسَلْنَا رِيحًا فَرَآهُ مُصْفَرًّا لَظَلُّوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ يَكْفُرُونَ. And if we send a cold wind over there, you know, harvest, and they see that the harvest had turned from green to yellow, لَظَلُّوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ يَكْفُرُونَ. Then they would, after that, certainly continue to disbelieve. فَإِنَّكَ لَا تُسْمِعُ الْمَوْتَى. So you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, cannot make the dead hear. وَلَا تُسْمِعُ سُمَّ الدُّعَاءِ إِذَا وَلَّوْ مُدْبُرِينَ. In the same way, you cannot make the deaf hear, especially when they turn their faces and go off. How can you convey your message to them? Either they are already dead, their spirits in them, they are dead. They are like tombs, you know, moving, just like taziyas. So they are the moving tombs and nothing else. Their arwah, their spirits are dead within them. They seem to be human beings, but they are not human beings. They are now only animals. أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. وَمَا أَنْتَ بِهَادِ الْعُمْيِ عَنْ ضَلَالَتِهِمْ. In the same way, you cannot guide the blind person from his errors. إِن تُسْمِعُ إِلَّا مَنْ يُؤْمِنُ بِآيَاتِنَا. You can make here only those who believe in our revelations. فَهُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And then they surrender. اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ ضَعْفٍ. Allah is He who created you from weakness. When a person comes in this world as a baby, he's very weak, very frail. Cannot do anything. ثُمَّ جَعَلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ضَعْفٍ قُوَّةً. Then after that weakness, there is the power, the strength. A man attains puberty, he is young, he is full of life. ثُمَّ جَعَلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ ضَعْفًا وَشَيْبًا. And then after that, the weakness and, you know, the grey hair, they come. You started with weakness, then there was the period of life when you are strong. Then again, when you have reached old age, hair are grey and your body is weak, frail. يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. This is the creation of Allah. He creates whatever He likes. وَهُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْقَدِيرُ. And He is all-knowing, all-powerful. وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ يُقْسِمُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ. And the day when that hour will come, that day of resurrection will come. Yuqsamul mujrimoon. Then these people, they will swear, ma labisu ghayra sa'atin, that they didn't remain in the world more than an hour. Whole life of this, maybe 80 years or 90 years or 70 years, would appear to be as if it was 1 hour. كَذَلِكَ كَانُوا يُفَكُونَ. In this way they were being deluded. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ وَالْإِيمَانَ لَقَدْ لَبِسْتُمْ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْبَعْثِ. Now those people who were given the knowledge and iman and belief and faith, they would say, you have lived in the book of Allah to the day of resurrection. This is the day of resurrection. فَهَذَا يَوْمُ الْبَعْثِ. Now this is the day of resurrection, when you have been resurrected from your graves. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. But you were not knowing it. You were not accepting it. You were not believing it. فَيَوْمَئِذٍ لَا يَنْفَعُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مَعْذِرَتُهُمْ. So on that day, the excuses will be of no use for those people who had done wrong to themselves. وَلَا هُمْ يُسْتَعْتَبُونَ. And nor will they be allowed to apologize. There is, you know, a position when you are angry with somebody, but you wish, if he apologizes, I will forgive him. But this anger can increase to a level, no apology. Now you don't let him apologize. There is no room for any apology. So this is what is meant with Quran by Walahum Yustatabun. Neither excuses will be entertained, nor they will be given permission or leave to apologize. رَبْنَا لِلنَّاسَ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ. And we have struck in this Quran for the guidance of the people all similitudes. We have described our way in all the ways, different styles, different words, different sequences. وَلَئِنْ جَيْتَهُمْ بِآيَةٍ. And when you come to them with a new ayah, لَا يَقُولَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِنْ أَنْتُمْ إِلَّا مُبْتِلُونَ. These people who disbelieve, they will surely say, no, but you are forging and creating falsehood. كَذَلِكَ يَتْبَعُ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْقُلُوبِ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. In this way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts a seal on the hearts of those who don't have knowledge. As we have in the very first section of Surah Al-Baqarah, خَتَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ أَبْصَارِهِمْ غِشَاوَةٌ. Whose to whomsoever truth is revealed, and his heart says, yes, this is correct, this is true, you must accept, but he doesn't accept. Out of his haughtiness, for example, out of his thought that it will mean that he has succeeded, I am failed. He is higher than me then, if I accept is what he is saying. Now, if this is the condition, after some time, then Allah Ta'ala puts a seal on the heart. Now, no advice can enter this heart. No admonition can enter this heart. No sermon can be beneficial for this heart. So this is the sunnah of Allah. Fasbir. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the last instruction in this surah, fasbir, persevere, endure with patience. إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. The promise of Allah is true. What is that promise? حَقٌّ عَلَيْنَا نُنْجِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. كَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نُنْجِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This is the promise on us, binding on us, that we shall deliver the people who believe. We shall help them. وَلَيَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ. This is our promise. Allah will definitely, definitely help those who help Him. And we read, you know, the last ayah of Surah Al-Ankabut. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Those who strive for our cause in our way, we shall surely, definitely, without doubt, guide them to our ways. So these are the promises of Allah. فَاسْبِرْ إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. The promise of Allah is true. وَلَا يَسْتَخِفَّنَّكَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. لَا يُوقِنُونَ. and see to it, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that those who don't believe, they will not be able to make you feel uneasy or feeble or discouraged or disheartened due to their opposition, due to their laughing at you, due to their mockery. Don't get, you know, feeble or discouraged or disheartened. Persevere in calling the people towards the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the end of Surah Ar-Rum.